Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In our previous class, we have been discussed about the sexually transmitted diseases. So already we have been discussed two types of sexually transmitted diseases. One we are calling it as a gonorrhea, another one we are calling it as a syphilis. So today's class, let us discuss another third type of sexually transmitted disease, call it as a genital herpes. So genital herpes, it is also one of the sexually transmitted diseases, like how the gonorrhea and syphilis, it will get transmitted through the sexual contact in the from the healthy from the infected person to the healthy person in the same manner. So genital herpes is also transmitted through the sexual, it will get transmitted from infected person to the healthy person through the sexual contact, and it is transmitted by the pathogen called as a virus. Whereas gonorrhea and syphilis, it is transmitted by the bacteria, where it is transmitted by a pathogen called as a bacteria. Whereas genital herpes, it is transmitted by which by pathogen means, or which microorganism means, it is transmitted by the virus. So what you call that virus name is HSV virus. HSV means herpes simplex virus. So this is the virus name. So what is the virus name is herpes simplex virus. So this with the help of this virus, the person, they'll get this diseases. And as I said here, it will get transmitted from infected person to the normal person or healthy person through the sexual contact. So next, let us discuss the what name is the symptoms here. What are the symptoms of the genital herpes here? So first symptom is tiredness, fever, headache, and tingling in the lower back, legs, and genital area. So this is the first symptoms of the genital herpes. What is the first symptom is, first of all, tiredness. The person will get the tiredness here. Usually, you know very well when we'll get the tiredness means when we do excess of work, hard work if we do means, or more work if we do means, that time the person will feel the tiredness. But here, the person without doing any work, the person will get the tiredness. So tiredness is nothing but here. So the person, they'll feel a tiredness here. Sustagi. Tiredness is nothing but, you know, do what we'll call means, we are calling it as a sustagi. So usually when we'll get this sustagi means, the person will, if they go and do the hard work, so then only they'll get the tiredness. Otherwise he will normally he will do his work, but the person who got this genital herpes, he will get the tiredness here. Then person will get the fever, headache, and next tingling in the lower back, legs, and genital area. So what is the meaning of a tingling means, tingling is nothing but pin, or else here needle. So therefore the person, they feel like needles are pricking on their body. Like how the, suppose anyone, they took the pain, and if they puncture to your body means, how you feel, how you will get the pain, in that same manner the person, they will get here. Tingling is nothing but here pin or else a needle. That means here the pin like unko kaise chubating, how they will feel here, in the same manner that condition we apply as a tingling. So tingling is nothing but, so what is the pinning of needling here? Suppose anyone konta bhi ek pin leko if they pin leko tumhe chubai, to how he will feel, in the same manner the person, they will get here tingling. That condition only we are calling it as a tingling. And where they will get the tingling means, in the lower back they will get here. That means on your buttocks they will get here. So they will get the tingling on their lower backs, they feel here. Not only in their lower backs here, even this tingling they will get in the legs here, and even they'll get the genital area. Even they'll get the tingling in the genital area. Genital area means, you know very well here, reproductive part where you will discharge your urine, all these things we are calling it as a genital part here. In that place also the person, they'll get the tingling. So which are the places the person, they'll get the tingling means, the person, they'll get the tingling on the lower back, legs, and the genital area. So this is the first symptom of the what means genital herpes. Next symptom is swollen lymph nodes in the groin here. Next what you mean, swollen lymph nodes here. So what is the meaning of swollen? Swollen is nothing but here swelling. So the person will get a swelling here. So groin means what here? Groin means fold. Groin means what here? Groin means folding here. So now the person, they'll get a swollen or folding, they will get, where they'll get means lymph nodes here. So you know very well, in our body varieties of systems are there, reproductive system, rather than respiratory system, digestive system, circulatory system. In that manner, we'll get the varieties of system. In the same manner, in our body, we'll be having the another one system called it as a lymphatic system. It is present. So in this lymphatic system, the person lymphatic system, what happen? The white in this lymphatic system, what it will be happen is the WBCs. That means here lymph it will be flowing. Lymphatic system, like how in the circulatory system, blood it will be flowing. In the same manner, in the lymphatic system, lymph it will be flowing. And you know very well what is the meaning of blood and the lymph. So lymph is exactly similar to the blood. Blood in but in the lymph, what it contains? Lymph and blood. So lymph and blood both are same only, just little bit difference it will be present. So in lymph, that the RBC will not be there. So lymph is exactly similar to the blood only. But in the lymph, what happens is RBC will be absent. In lymph, what it will be absent? RBC will be absent. In lymph, RBC will be absent. So that's why lymph, it will be appears in the white in color. But blood, it will be appears in a red in color. Why it will appears in a red in color is because in the blood, RBC will be present. And you know very well, RBC contains a hemoglobin, and this hemoglobin, it is giving a red color for the RBC. So due as the RBCs are present, the blood it will be appears in a red in color. So in the circulatory system, blood it will be flowing, whereas in the lymphatic system, the lymph it will be flowing. So in the same manner, continuously in our body, the lymphatic system it will be present. Just now in your textbook, they have been given the lymphatic system. See here, this is the lymphatic system. They have been given in your page number 154. So where it is present? It is present in your page number 154. So in your page number 154, they have given the lymphatic system. So this is the lymphatic system which has been given in your textbook. See, like this, these are all are the lymph. Like how circulatory system, it contains the blood vessels. In the same manner, blood vessels means which are the blood vessels? Arteries, veins, capillaries, all these things are present in the circulatory system. In the same manner, in the lymphatic system, what we will find means we will find the lymphatic vessel, we will find, and in that lymphatic vessels, lymph it will be flowing. And in this lymphatic vessels only we will find the lymph nodes. Here, which are the lymph nodes means, so when the two limbs, suppose here, example, see here, I will write here only. So suppose this is one lymph vessel and this is one lymph vessel. So when the two lymph vessels, it is crossing in this crossing, this place we are calling it as a lymph nodes. This place we are calling it as a lymph nodes. This is the lymph node. So like that in our body, so in complete throughout our body, we'll be having the many lymph nodes will be present. Just if you open your textbook and if you see in your page number 150, I will repeat another one time where it is present means it is present in your page number 154. So in your page numbers, they have been given this lymphatic system. This is the complete lymphatic system. Like this, the lymph vessels will be present. And here and there, we will find the lymph nodes. Now, what they are telling the second symptom means, second symptom is swollen lymph nodes in the ground. So what they are doing, second symptom, as I said, you shown you here lymph nodes, that lymph nodes, it will becomes a swollen. So this lymph nodes which is present in our body, it will becomes a swollen. Swollen means what here? Pugna. So lymph nodes, it will becomes a pugna. It will becomes a swollen in condition and in the foldings. And even what happened means where the foldings will be present, that place also it will shows the swelling. Swelling it will shows here. This is the second symptom of the genital herpes which will take place inside our body. Next here, severe pain during the urination. Next character, what they'll get here? The person, they'll get a severe pain during the urination. While they are discharging the urine, so they'll get a severe pain. Both for the male and the female, they'll get the pain. But when we are in normal, if we discharge the urine, we'll not get any pain. Whether we'll get a pain? Will not get any pain. So that's why the person who got this disease here, the severe pain will be there in the urination. And next character, next symptom what here means, next symptom is fluid filled blisters on the genitalia and buttocks. So what here means, fluid filled blisters on the genitalia and buttocks here. Next symptom what here means, fluid filled blisters. Blisters means what here? Bobbe. In Pana, what they'll tell here? bobbe. Bobbe, it will get a form. And where they will get him is genitalia. Genitalia means in the, you know very well, reproductive part they will get here. And even on the buttocks. Buttocks means what here? Buttocks means dhopar. So as they have dhopar, that is nothing but lower back, as I said you here. So buttocks means what here? Buttocks means dhopar. So on their dhopar and even the genitalia, what they will get him is the blisters, it will be appear. So many times here, if any hot substance fall on your body, on your hand, or else here, if your hot water falls on your hand, means finally what happen? You will get, your hand will get burn, and your blister, it will get appears. So that blisters only which is filled with a fluid, and that is on that condition only we are counted as a blister. Here also same, and especially on the genitalia, on the buttocks, what they having means they will get the blisters, and that blisters it is filled with the fluid. If you puncture that blisters, means the fluid it will be discharged, but that blister, that fluid, if it spread on your body, means automatically that blisters it will be go on spread on your body. So that's why we should not break that blisters. So as a fluid filled blisters on the genitalia and the buttocks. Buttocks means dhopar and genitalia means the reproductive part. In both the places, not all over the body, especially in the genitalia and the buttocks, they'll get a blisters. Blisters means the bobbe. In Kannada, they'll tell the bobbe. So like that, they will get a, which is filled with the fluid. Next, infection spread by the rupture of the blisters. So as I said here, if you puncture that blisters, so just if you take the needle and if puncture that one, means automatically what happen? The fluid, it will be the fluid it will be comes out from that blister, but that fluid when it is spread to your body, that means automatically complete throughout your body, there is a chance of getting the blisters. These are the symptoms of the genital herpes. Next is prevention. So prevention, you know very well, same prevention which has been appear in the gonorrhea and syphilis, it will comes here. Avoiding multiple sexual contact and using condoms during the sexual intercourse with the risky partner. So that's why we should not go for the multiple sex here. So we should avoid the multiple sex, because here, so in which person, which type of sexual disease it is present, we can't predict here. And externally it will not appear. So that's why we should avoid the multiple sex here. And even while they are, we are doing the intercourse here, sexual intercourse, we have to use the condoms, which is one of the safer thing. So because the semen which will be released here, it will not take entry into the person body, so that way we can avoid the sexually transmitted disease. Next treatment, what is the treatment means? It is treated by the oral drugs called the, so acyclovir, valacyclovir, and or even we are going to say famcyclovir. So these are the drugs which we have been given for the infected person who got this disease, called it as a genital herpes. Another one time I'll tell you here, oral drugs. These are all of the oral drugs. Oral drugs. Oral drugs to whom we have missed, the drugs which will be injected from their mouth here. So such drugs we are calling as the oral drugs we are calling. So we are names, what is the name? Same is acyclovir, then valacyclovir, or even we are going to say famcyclovir. So these are the treatment. So this is about your one of the disease, call it as a genital herpes. Next disease, let us discuss here. Next fourth type of sexually transmitted disease, what we are calling, means we are calling it as a genital rats we are calling. So what is this means? It is also a sexually transmitted disease. So by caused by the human papilloma virus. So this is also caused by the what here? It is also caused by the virus. What you call this virus name means that virus name we are calling it as a human papilloma virus. So genital herpes, it is also caused by the virus here. What you call that virus means herpes simplex virus. That is we are calling it as a HSV, and that is caused by the HSV, and this is called by the HPV. Same it will come, but there yes it will come, here P it will come. So but full form it is different here. Human papillomavirus, there it will comes a herpes simplex virus. It is caused by the virus. Keep remember this one, it is important for your board a NEET exam, especially in NEET primary related to this topic the questions may be asked here. So which pathogen means it is a virus. What is that virus name here is human papilloma virus, and you know very well it is also transmitted from infected person to the healthy person. Next let us see the symptoms. What are the symptoms here? First symptoms is appearance of rats on the skin, external genitalia, around the anogenital region. So first symptoms what they will get him is appearance of a rat. Rat means what here? Yesterday as I said in my previous class, rats means what? Rat means purpuri. So initially we'll get our body. Vrats means what here? Vrats means purpuri. So purpuri we will get on the skin. So before it was not there, but the person, when as soon as he get this disease, automatically on their skin they'll get this vrats. And even not only on the skin, even the vrats will be appear on their external genitalia. They'll get here. External genitalia means, you know very well, the reproductive part, outside reproductive part. And which is the outside reproductive part of the male means? So penis is the our male, and the vulva is the female. And even so, around the anogenital region, anogenital region means, as I said you here, the gap which is present between the anus. So the gap present between the anus and the genital region. So genital is nothing but here the genital. Genital is nothing but here in male. In female means vulva. In female means vulva, and I mean male means penis here. So, and both what it contains, this is the anus. So from vulva to anus, the gap which is present, this gap we are calling it as a anogenital region. So the gap between the anus, ano means anus, the gap present between the anus, from the anus only will discharge the motion which will be connected to your reproductive system. And genitalia means the, it will be connected to the reproductive system. So that means here we'll discharge the urine. So between the motion and urine discharge, the space which will be present, that place we are going to say anogenital region. So on this place, what happens is the vrats, it will be developed. So vrats, where it will be developed? Vrats means what? Vrats means purpuri. So vrats will be developed on the skin, external genitalia, and around the anogenital region. Next, what symptom? What here? In women, vrats may enter vagina and cervix here. Even if the female she got this disease, means, so for the female, the vrats, it will, where it will be taken tree, not only it will present on the external genitalia, it is not present, or not only present in the vulva region, even it will take entry into the, what here means, it may take entry into the cervix and the vagina. So this is the vagina and this is the cervix. So vrats will be appear and take entry into this vagina and the cervix. This is the uterus. This is the female reproductive system. Roughly I have been drawn here. So like this. So this is the uterus and this is the cervix here. So the vrats may be appear on this cervix region and even vagina. It may take entry into the female body. It is now associated with cancer of cervix and tumors of vagina and anus. So if we didn't take the tumor treatment, means this vrats later it may converted into the tumor form. Tumor means what here? Gadde. Gadde kata kya? Dullaika. So dullaika is a, it will get a form here. That is, we are going to tumor. And with that tumor, it is nothing but it may leads to the cancer. And that cancer, it may appears on the cervix region, or even it may appears on the vagina, or even it may appears to the anus. So that means here, the person, they will get this cancer. So if the cervix or vagina means in the female body, they'll get the cervix cancer, they will get the vagina cancer, and even they may get the chances of getting the anus cancer. In case of male means the person, they will get the male anus cancer also, they may get here. The vrats which will be go on developing and finally it will form a tumor. So dullaika is, it will get a form here, or else we have gadde. In Kannada we will call it as a gadde. So which may leads to the, and what here means, it may leads to the cancer. So genital herpes, finally if we didn't take the proper treatment, means in the initial stage, so it may cause to the, it may leads to the cancer. So these are the symptoms of the, what here means, these are the symptoms of the, so what you mean, genital vrats here. So these are the symptoms of what here, these are the symptoms of the genital vrats here. So sorry, I have said here genital herpes, I said here. So genital vrats, these are the symptoms of what here, these are the symptoms of the genital vrats. Next, what are the prevention here? So let us know prevention. Prevention means same, it will comes here. Avoiding multiple sexual contact and even the homosexuality also. So what is the means, avoiding multiple sexual contact means, so avoiding the sex with the many persons we have to avoid. So and next, even we have to avoid the homosexuality. Homosexuality means sex with the intercourse with the same sex here. So we have to avoid the doing the intercourse with the same sex here. Usually say intercourse will be, our copulation will be done between the male and the female here. But in our society, there are many persons that are present here where they'll go the intercourse with the male and female. So if the male, he is going the intercourse with the male, or female, she is going the intercourse with the female, that condition we are calling it as a homosexuality. So that's why the homo means what here? Homo meaning same. So male and female female male male will go for the intercourse and female female will go for the intercourse. So that's why we are calling it as a homosexuality. So we should avoid this homosexuality. Next, even then, next, as you know very well, using the condom during the sexual intercourse with the risky partner. So these are the prevention. Next, we will come to the treatment here. So what is the treatment means? It is treated with the alpha interferons, podophyllum, and a preparation for the podoflax, etc. Brass can be removed surgery by using the drugs called a condolex here. So what I mean is, so treatment, what I mean is, they are giving the medicines here, drugs they are giving, which drugs name is alpha interferons. So these are the treatment here, these are the drugs names, call it as a alpha interferons here, or else here even we are going to say podophyllum. So podophyllum, so these are the different type of drugs here. A preparation here, podophyllax, etc. Even what happen here means another one type of drugs it is present. What we are means, we are calling it as a, so podophyllax here, podophyllum preparation, these are the drugs here, podophyllum preparation, call it as a podophyllax, etc. So these are the different drugs, alpha interferons and podophyllax here. Preparation of this podophyllax, we are calling it as a podophyllum preparation, we are calling. Now these are the two different types of drugs which will be given for the genital warts here. Next, even the warts can be removed by the surgery, the warts which has been appear on their body, so even that can be removed by the surgery method by doing the operation, or else by using the drug called it as a condolex here, or else even by using the drugs we can remove the warts. Surgery is also one method to remove the warts here. Another one is the condolex, is also another one type of drugs here which is used by the patient in order to remove the warts here. Without doing the surgery, by giving the just drugs here, we are removing the warts. So these are the two different techniques here in order to avoid the, what here means, warts in the body. Condolex, this is the drugs. So this is about what him is, genital warts. So this is another one type of sexually transmitted disease. Next, we will move to the next type of sexually transmitted disease. So which is the next type of sexually transmitted disease means? So we are calling it as a chlamydiasis. Which is the next type here? Chlamydiasis, fifth type. So till now we have been discussed the, how many types here? Four is over. One is the gonorrhea, syphilis. Third one is the genital herpes. And fourth one is the genital warts here. So genital herpes, genital warts, today's class we have been discussed. Next, let us discuss the another type of disease, called it as a chlamydiasis here. So it is also a sexually transmitted disease caused by the bacterium. So it is also one of the sexually transmitted disease caused by the bacteria. So it is caused by whom? It is caused by the bacteria. What you call that bacterium is bacterium chlamydia trichomates here. So what we call that bacteria name? Bacterium chlamydia trichomatis here. Trichomatis. What is that bacteria name? Bacterium chlamydia trichomatis. This is the scientific name of the bacteria. Now it is transmitted from infected person to the healthy person. This is also transmitted from whom is? It is also transmitted from infected person to the healthy person. Now let us see symptoms. What are the symptoms here? First symptom, thick pus discharged from the genitalia. Next symptom, what here? A thick pus discharged from the genitalia. So that means here, from their reproductive part, a pus formation will be released. Pus means what here? Pus means a pip. You have seen that pip. Already you know very well, if you get any wound formation, means wound is nothing but phoda. So if you get any wound formation, means automatically from that the pus formation will be released here. Pus will be white in color and thick in condition. In the same manner, here also thick pus, it will get discharged. Now, thick pus from which part it will get discharged? It will get discharged from their genitalia. Genitalia means their reproductive part, it will get discharged here. Next, burning sensation during the urination. Next, what happened? So, while they discharge the urine, the person, they will get a burning sensation while discharging the urine. Whenever they discharge the urine, the burning sensation they will feel in their reproductive part here. Easily, they are unable to discharge the urine. Next, inflammation of urethra, cervix here. In female genital, what happened is, so cervix and urethra, just now as I shown you about the reproductive structure of the, what here is female. So see here, this is the reproductive structure. So this is the vagina and this is the cervix here. In this region, what happened is, in the female body, inflammation, it will be taken place. Inflammation means what here? Swellingness, phugara. So whenever you know very well here, if you get any wound formation or anything here means, so we will get a swellingness, phugara. So in the same manner, so in the female body, in this vagina and this cervix region, inflammation or phugara, it will be taken place. Next one, pain in the lower part of the abdomen in the female. So in the female body, what they'll get here? Severe pain will be there below the abdomen here. So abdomen means stomach. So below the stomach, the female, she'll get a severe pain in the female here. And finally, if you didn't take the treatment, means it will lead to the infertility or sterility. So if they didn't take the proper treatment for this, it may lead to the infertility. But nowadays here, for every disease, we're having the particular treatment here. Just as soon as we find the ones first starting in stem symptom is, the person will consult for the doctor and easily they'll come to know the disease and they'll take the treatment here. But in olden periods, what happened is, there was no doctor, no medicines, nothing was there. So if they get any disease here, the person, they have to suffer with that disease, and finally the disease, it will be spread into the body, and finally what happened is, it may bring the infertility or sterility in the person body. And this is also one of the reason to decrease the population at that time. But nowadays the population, it is increasing because we having the good medical care, it is present. So due to that good treatment, what happened is, many diseases we are curing. So that's why death rate, it has become a less in condition. So as the death rate is less here, population rate, it is increasing. So in this manner, so that's why finally it may lead to the infertility or sterility. When it will comes to infertility or sterility, means if the person, he didn't take the correct treatment, if he neglect all these things here, means symptoms, means finally it may convert into the sterility or infertility. If infertility means, the person are unable to give birth to their own young ones. Sterility also means same. Infertility also means same only. They are unable to give birth to their young ones here. Next, prevention. Prevention means same, it will come. Avoiding multiple sexual contact and using the condoms during the sexual intercourse. Things with a risky partner. If the person, they are having any problem, if you feel risk in condition, means then it is better used to, then it is best to use the condom to avoid the disease here. So treatment, what is the treatment here? So treatment is, so it is treated by using a antibiotic drugs here. We are giving the antibiotic drugs, which are the antibiotic drugs means erythromycin, tetracycline, chloromycetin, azithromycin. So these are the different types of drugs it is given for the person who got this disease. Which is the disease? This disease we are calling as a chlamydiasis. So this disease, what we are calling it as a chlamydiasis, which is caused by the bacteria. So this is about your chlamydiasis. This is 5th type of sexually transmitted disease. So remaining, next we'll discuss next disease is trichomoniasis. That is nothing but we'll discuss in our next class. Next disease is trichomoniasis, or else even we are calling it as a vaginitis. So this disease we'll discuss in our next class.